These are the very best ducks at laying eggs. Believe it or not, they're even capable of laying 365 eggs in 1 year. Greetings, friends. I'm Mike the Fit Farmer, and years ago, I moved my family out of the city to homestead in the country. Join me as I share our adventures of growing stuff, striving to live a healthy lifestyle, and so much more. Oh, and we live in a yurt. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment below, subscribe to my channel, turn on notifications, and share this video with a friend. Alright, you got it on there?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, we're on the string here to continue on with our new ones. Okay, you got that one on there? Alright, gotta get this here, right at the line. Okay, this one, adjust it here. There we go. That look good to you?
Yes.
So, a little over 2 feet deep. Today is day three of my very big duck project. And on the first 2 days, my sons and I, we worked on building this first enclosure for one of my breeds of meat ducks. We started off by measuring out the area, marking where our posts would go. Then we busted out the post hole diggers and started digging some holes for our posts to go into. After we finished that, I mixed up the concrete and poured it in with our posts.
Line up the hole.
Then on the second day, we enclosed the post with fencing. And I even built a gate so that way we can easily enter in their enclosure. And my goal is to set up an enclosure for each of my breeds of ducks. I've been raising ducks for a number of years now, and they have actually become my favorite animal here on the farm. Even our one-year-old likes ducks, and he recently added the word duck to his vocabulary.
Say duck. What are those, Hezekiah? There's ducks there. Way to go. Good job, duck.
And in this first initial phase of building these enclosures, I'm only building half of the area, just so that way we can make sure we have an enclosure for each one. And then I plan to expand each enclosure to this area back here, doubling their size. I have several systems for raising ducks. With my meat ducks, I primarily raise them in chicken tractors that will move daily on the fresh grass. For my egg-laying ducks, I like to rotate them within the electric netting around various places on the farm, so that way they have access to fresh grass. But my goal for this area is to provide an enclosed space for the families of ducks that I want to breed from. That way, I'll be able to reproduce my various breeds of ducks on my own.
There.
Ha 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 ha! Alrighty, before we can move on any further, first have to let these posts dry in place. And my goal with this big duck project is to use as much wood harvested from this property as possible for my post. So we should be able to do that for the most part, because cedar wood is actually naturally rot resistant and pest resistant. So while my posts are drying over here, there's one thing that I really need to do and haven't done yet for the first enclosure. To keep the ducks in good health, it is best to provide them with fresh bedding. Actually, with most animals that are stationary, it's best to provide them with a fresh bedding to be on, so that way they're not just sitting in their own poop. And adding this bedding also helps with other organisms as well. With these ducks, I will allow them times of free ranging around the pond. But for the overall health of the pond and for other creatures that are in it, I won't let them do it every day. So I also bring them fresh grass to eat on. Most ducks, like our pekins here, prefer to lay on the ground. And with ducks, well, sometimes they lay where they're supposed to, and sometimes they don't. Like some laid right here on the ground and not in their nesting box. And that's just the way ducks are. Pekins are raised mostly as meat ducks, weighing about 6 to 10 pounds finished weight per bird. But they can also be a good dual or multi-purpose duck, because pekins can lay anywhere from 125 to 225 eggs per year. So average it out, about 175 eggs per year. But in the second enclosure that we're working on, the ducks that I'm gonna be putting in there lay even more eggs than that. A lot more eggs than that. Actually, about 100 more eggs per year than the pekins. Nice and hard. Time to move on. Thank you. recycled piece here, this little bowed. See if we can fix that.
Down at the bottom. Ready?
Wait, here.
Down at the bottom. Yep. Hold the screw. There we go. We got that in there much better.
As I've gotten older, one of the things that I find to be really fulfilling is passing on and sharing knowledge to both my kids as well as to others. And right now I'm in the process of building an online area in which I'm teaching people how to live a more homegrown centered life. And on there, I'm having uncensored content that will include things such as raising ducks, gardening, herbalism, cooking in the kitchen, how to live a healthful life, and so much more. Once I open this area, it will only be open for a limited time, so make sure you get on the wait list to be the first to know about when I open this area, because it will have a library full of information that is uncensored and that you won't find here on YouTube. I also will be doing live webinars and Q&As with people, as well as having special guests that will be helping me provide in-depth information for helping people to live a homegrown life.
All right, Micah, ready for the next step?
With both chickens and ducks, usually the better layers are smaller in size. So with that in mind, we decided to double up the fencing with some netting that had smaller holes, just so hopefully we won't have any unintended escapes. On the fourth day of this big duck project, it was time to put in my best egg laying ducks. But we did have a little yucky problem to deal with.
All right,
so I am not looking forward to going in here. Ugh, we've had a lot of rain lately. And these ducks have been here a little bit too long, and it's pretty yucky. But I have to, we have to, because some of these are the egg layers that we're moving into our new area. But I don't wanna get my shirt all dirty. I think I need to put my hoodie back on. And I really didn't wanna fall, so I was trying to be as careful as I could. But regretfully, I did slip a little here and a little there.
Yeah. Almost did a split at the same time though.
And as I was trying to get this one duck. That was a close one. And one of the techniques that I have found to work with catching ducks is you want to kind of do a waddle side to side to kind of confuse them of where you're going to go. And as I was doing this, my oldest son, Josiah, was able to catch him with the net.
Beautiful ducks. I love the coloring on them. Yes, I do, even with all the mud. And yeah, it's beautiful. Just beautiful.
The Welsh Harlequin could also be used as a dual purpose duck. Their average process weight is around 4.5 to 5 pounds, which is lighter than the Pekins and makes them better suited to be egg layers. They lay white eggs, and a good healthy hen can lay anywhere from 240 to 330 eggs a year, with an average of 285 eggs per year. And while we were gathering up our best egg layers, well, I decided let's go ahead and gather up our other breed of duck that I also want to preserve. And it's actually a better egg layer than the Welsh Harlequin.
Push them on back.
And this right here is one of the champion, or the champion, egg laying ducks. Khaki Campbell. Raise these right here as little ducklings over the winter, moving them around the garden in the chicken tractor. And now they're going to their new area. Got it.
I'm trying to get a male.
Get in there, get in there. Now, khaki camels can be pretty loud, but these are the very best ducks at laying eggs. Believe it or not, they're even capable of laying 365 eggs in 1 year. And the Livestock Conservancy actually states that this has happened. These ducks generally lay 250 to 340 eggs a year, with an average being somewhere around 295 or 300 eggs a year. And even in the winter, when chickens stop laying eggs, these ducks are still cranking them out. So if you're looking for a great egg laying duck, I highly recommend the khaki Campbell. Well, I really wasn't planning on moving the khaki Campbells yet because I want an enclosure for each breed, but I needed the chicken tractor because I have a brooder full of chickens that need to come outside ASAP. So I was like, let's just move the khaki camels down with the Welsh Harlequin for now. And that next day when we went down there to gather eggs, there was a ton of duck eggs.
Oh, that's a lot.
Sure is, man.
Wow. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yeah. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19.
We got some more over there. 20, 21, 22, 23. So you got four more there?
Yeah.
27 right there, man.
You need another basket.
Oh, one more.
Yeah.
Man, way to go. Way to go, ladies. Good job. And that is why these are the best egg-laying ducks here. Big difference between my Welsh and khaki egg numbers versus the Pekins. Big time difference. Once I build each breed their own enclosure, I'll be able to reproduce the breeds myself, making it more sustainable, like farmers used to do back in the day. Also, if there's ever an event where the post office, for whatever reason, is not shipping live birds anymore, well, at least I'll be able to reproduce these ducks on my own. And since the khakis and the Welsh are together, I'm not gonna incubate their eggs. So, we had a whole bunch of eggs to wash.
Okay, some deep dirt here. Clean them just a tad bit more. I have to do the chicken eggs generally because the ducks, I'll lay wherever. Sometimes they lay in the nesting boxes. A lot of times they don't.
When I'm washing eggs, I generally like to turn on the faucet really low with hot water.
Scrub pad here, that makes a difference. There we go.
I don't know how many eggs I've washed over the years, but I've washed a ton of eggs and just gradually get faster and better the more that you wash.
And after washing all those eggs, to finish it off, I brought in one of our champion khaki Campbell ducks inside the house to take a picture for this thumbnail.